Hi everyone, my name is Mike, and today we're going to explore how to customize the behavior of your mobs and entities inside of Minecraft. To get started, what we're going to do is we're going to start with a cow and make it an angry cow, the kind of cow that attacks players that can do some damage as people go about and do their things. Now, I'm going to use a site called mctools.dev. This is a simple website with a number of different project starters that automates the process of getting started, customizing the folder names, the identifiers, and those kinds of things for your project so that you don't have to. It'll get us off the ground much quicker compared to downloading some files and doing it ourselves inside of Visual Studio Code. And in my case, I'm gonna start with a cow example. We're gonna customize the behavior for this. I'm gonna select new. I'm gonna call this the angry cow like so. And then let's get started with this project. Now, what you can see inside of mctools.dev, once this project is loaded, there's a number of different things I can go customize, but in my case, I want to select this cow entity types. And what it's going to do is open up the JSON file, basically the configuration file for how this cow works. So you can see a number of different elements inside of this file. There's a number of main groupings that we're going to talk about: component groups, components, and events. So let's take a deeper dive on how components, component groups, and events all work together. Okay, so when you're actually configuring the behaviors of an entity, you'll see an entity JSON file, which has a number of different important areas for configuring how that entity works. First among these is the description, which has common properties like the identifier of the entity and maybe some small behaviors like whether it will work in experimental only. Next up, you have the components section, and this is a really important section for establishing the base configuration of that entity. So certain things like, how does this entity move? Does it walk? Does it swim? Does it fly? Those things you'll find typically inside of the component section because they never typically change, and so you just want to set them once in the component section and then not worry about them any further. Next up, you have the component groups, and for the component groups, you can think of these as a bunch of different overrides for how that mob will work. So for example, very typically what you'll see for a lot of mobs is that they have these component groups for when the mob is a baby and when the mob is an adult. And when the mob is a baby, what it does is it sets some properties like the overall scale and size of the mob so that a baby mob is smaller naturally than an adult mob would be. So that's just a case in point of using component groups to override the scale property for a particular mob. Finally, what you'll see is this concept of events. And events are what do the work to actually add, activate, or remove, deactivate certain component groups on top of that mob. So that's how behaviors cause the entity to change over time. So let's take a quick look at how this works. You're probably familiar with spiders inside of Minecraft. Spiders are generally peaceful and go about their business during the day. They're kind of in a neutral mode, but at nighttime, then they'll start to attack players, which is an unfun behavior. But you can see a little bit about how this works by studying the component groups and the events of the mob. So there's a component group called spider neutral. This is when the spider is just peaceably going about its business in the overworld. And what you can see from there is that there's this element defined, an environment sensor component, which says that when the brightness goes below a certain threshold, .49, that's going to trigger an event called become hostile. And the become hostile event is fairly simple and straightforward. What it does is it removes the neutral mode from that spider and then adds on a component group called spider underscore hostile. Now, when you look at that spider hostile component group, there's a new behavior that's been added to the spider, behavior nearest attackable target, which says, hey, spider, go look for some players to go attack. And then there's another trigger here called on target acquired, which when the target, when the spider actually finds a target, finds a player, it's going to trigger this event called become angry. The become angry event then adds this component group called spider angry. And the spider angry component group has a number of additional behaviors that get added onto that spider. For example, leaping at the target and doing a melee box style attack. And so here you can see how all of these different elements work together to basically dictate how that spider works over time. And you can actually see the reverse, that a spider beat will go from angry to neutral when the brightness of the world exceeds a certain threshold. So you can see the same type of chain of component groups and events for taking a spider out of hostile mode when it becomes daytime. So now that we understand how component groups and components and events work together, let's go and customize the component set for this mob so that we can change the base behavior of how it works. And to make this kind of cow an attacking cow, we're gonna add a number of different components in here. The first thing we're gonna wanna do is add a Minecraft attack component. which basically just specifies the amount of damage that this cow will do when it's doing an attack. And because I have a little bit of IntelliSense and auto completion for me, this is a little bit of an easier process when you do this on a tool like Visual Studio Code or mctools.dev to make the addition of custom JSON a little easier. And in our case, let's give the cow a damage factor of 3. Now, there's two other elements that are important for making this kind of a cow something that will go attack. We need to add a behavior, which is an AI gesture, that will tell this how to attack and find other things. So we're going to use the behavior, behavior.nearestattackableTarget. And you can see it fills out a number of different properties for how this is going to work. And in our case, what we're going to want to do is we're going to say, here's the kind of things that you should go attack, cow. And we're going to say that these are the types of entities. And then what we're going to do is add a filter, like so, and then add certain types of behaviors. Now, we don't need all of this kind of specificity, so let's just go customize this a little bit further. What we're going to do is say, let me get rid of those curly braces. Okay, we're going to add just a very simple test. Let's see, like this, and let me clean up all the braces. Okay, now we're, I think, good to go. We're going to say if the entity type is of the family, and we're going to say of the family player, and we're going to say subject other, like so. Okay, so now we set up a very simple filter that says, when you're looking for something to go attack, find something that's near and close to you, and there's a number of properties that we can go configure. But in our case, what we want to say is just find a player to go attack. And then the final thing that we're going to do is we're going to add a behavior melee attack component, which basically says, here's how you should go, you know, prosecute your attack. So in this case, I'm going to say behavior.melee. Let's see, let's try this again. Behavior.melee attack, like so. And then add a number of different properties there. And what we're going to do is we're also going to want to work with the priorities for how all these behaviors come together. So behaviors are basically what dictates that's what's going on in the brain of the cow in terms of how it should think about things. And it uses this priority flag to determine the relative priority of all the different things that it has going on. We're going to say the melee attack is a priority of 3. We're going to say that the nearest attackable target is a priority of 2. Okay, and so now we've set up our cow so that it's got an attack behavior. So let's go ahead and see how this works. I'm just going to say download a world, a flat world with packs, which will download a particular type of world. And then I'm going to open this up, which will then have the behavior of opening this up inside of Minecraft. Okay, so now let's go ahead and just take a quick look. I'm going to summon, let's see, we've got our angry cow like this. And now you can say, okay, well now the cow looks like a normal cow, but when we turn it into survival mode, you can see that now this cow is a little angry and it's coming to attack us and do some damage. That's not very nice, but you can see how through some simple component customizations, we've changed the behavior of this cow to make it the kind of mob that will attack players and the like. So that's just a very quick introduction of getting started with customizing the behavior components that you see to change the behavior of the mobs and entities you create in Minecraft. Thanks for watching.